In this session, I am going to present simulation of diode clamper circuits using LTSpice. Before moving on to the simulation part, I will briefly explain what is diode clamper and the operation of the clamper circuits briefly. Clamper circuits are used to place either the positive or negative peak of a signal at a desired level. That means the DC component is simply added or subtracted to or from the input signal which we are applying to the clamper circuit. So the clamper circuit is also referred to as an IC restorer or AC signal level shifter. So the circuit which is shown here is the positive clamper circuit, where you can see how the AC signal is shifted at the output side. So for example, consider that the input you are applying to the clamper circuit is 10 volt peak or 20 volt peak to peak. So from the origin it is 10 volt minus and 10 volt plus, and the signal will be repeated. But have a look at the output here. The output is shifted from 0, so it is going to 40 volt from 0. That means 20 volt from 0. Here it is from 0, 10 volt positive and 10 volt negative, but here from 0 it is 20 volt positive. But a small portion of the negative half cycle is just lying under 0. I will just explain how the positive clipper circuit works. For that we need to know one important point. Consider that the input voltage source is connected in such a way so that positive get connected to the anode of the diode and negative get connected to the capacitor. That means we need negative half cycle to start with. So the first half cycle of the input should be negative. By making the connection in this way, we can achieve that. Therefore, what will happen during the first half cycle, that is the negative half cycle in this case, the diode get forward bias. So the capacitor which is connected in the loop will get charged, and it will get charged until Vp minus 0.7 volt, that is the forward bias breakdown voltage of the diode. So till the negative peak it will get charged, and when it started decreasing, then the diode will become reverse bias and therefore the capacitor charging will get stopped. But from this point the capacitor will try to discharge. The only option for the capacitor to discharge is supplying it to the resistive load. So in that way the output is getting shifted from its original shape. What you are seeing here is the negative clamper circuit. So the basic difference between positive clamper and negative clamper circuits are the connection of source and the diode in the circuit. If you have a look at the source, the first half cycle is positive half cycle here, therefore the upper terminal of supply should be positive and the lower terminal of supply should be negative. That means positive terminal of the supply will be connected to the capacitor and negative terminal will be connected to the ground and also to the cathode of the diode. That means the diode is also, the connection of diode is also reversed. Then go and check the output of the negative clamper circuit. In the negative clamper circuit, the voltage is shifted below 0. In the positive clamper circuit, voltage is shifted above 0. In negative clamper circuit, voltage is shifted below 0. So these are the basic difference between positive and negative clamper circuit. We will move on to the simulation of positive and negative clamper using LTSpice. Open LTSpice, go to File, New Schematic. To do the simulation of diode clamper circuit, whether it is positive or negative Coulomb circuit. The components we require to design the circuit are a diode, voltage source, a capacitor, a load resistor and the ground. I will start with the voltage source. Click on component, select, type voltage and select voltage source, and you can place the voltage source here, then press escape. For the positive Coulomb circuit, positive terminal of the voltage is connected to the ground and negative terminal of the voltage source is connected to the capacitor. Therefore, we need to rotate the voltage source. So, in order to do so, what you can do is you go and click on drag, then just click on the source or the component which you need to rotate. Just click once so that the component can be moved. Now, you use Ctrl R to rotate the device. So, any component or device can be rotated by using Ctrl R. Now, you place it. Go and select a diode also need to be rotated. Use Ctrl R before you place it, then click to place it, press escape. Now go and select a resistor will be in the same way as it appear, place it, press escape, select a diode also need to be rotated, so use Ctrl R twice to rotate it. As much times you press Ctrl R, it will be rotating. So place it here finally. So when you do this, it will go along. So press escape. If you want to move the components together, what you can do is you can click drag and select all of them together. Once again, I will do it. So you can zoom out the circuit or zoom in the circuit by using your mouse. Then you zoom in the circuit and select drag, select all the components, move them to the place where you wanted to, then you can zoom out the circuit for better visibility. I will select the ground, place it, press escape. Now connect all the components using the wire. Connections are done. Now we need to assign the values for all the components and the source. I have just shown you a circuit diagram where the values of the components are given. We'll start with the voltage source. The voltage source value is 24 volt. When you right click on the source, a window will pop up. This is showing only DC value, so go to advanced, select sign and put the amplitude as 24 volt and frequency is 50 hertz. Click OK. That value will appear here. You have to make sure that it is sign 24 volt and 50 hertz. Right click on the capacitor value is 10 microfarad, so you type 10U. In all SPICE simulation softwares, micro is automatically taken by typing U. You can see that here it is C. When you click OK, automatically it will appear as 10 micro. Change the value of the resistor, 10K, and the diode value is, the first diode is what we have selected. Done. So the circuit component parameters are assigned. Now go and click on simulation. New window will pop up where you need to give the stop time. So for 50 hertz frequency, time period is 20 milliseconds. We are going to analyze the circuit for 5 cycles. Therefore, 5 into 20 will be 100 milliseconds. Put 100 m. Now the window popped up for the graph. Right click on the window and select add plot. The window, by default this graph window is black. I have changed it to white. If you are not aware of how to do that, please watch the video for simulation of diode clippers using LT spice. In that video I clearly explained how to do how to change the window background from black to white. Now you can go and click on simulation, then select this window. By default the first window is selected, so you can move your cursor on the voltage source. Input waveform is appearing here, 24 volt negative, 24 volt positive. First half cycle is negative. Then you can select the second window now, otherwise that also will appear on the first window. Select the second window, click on simulation again, move your cursor to the load resistor, you are getting the output waveform. Have a look at the waveforms now. You can maximize this window so that these windows will appear beside to each other. Have a look at the waveform clearly now. This is 24 volt positive peak to 24 volt negative peak. This is just going getting shifted above zero, with that 0.7 volt appearing below zero. Then this value is little different from the peak to peak value. You can do the calculation in order to know why these values are appearing like this. However, this graph is right. Now you can go and copy the graph from here, copy bitmap to clipboard, then open your Word file. I have already placed some figures here, I will remove them all. Just place your graph, go back, select this one. I prefer to use snipping tool to copy the circuit. Just snip the portion of the circuit you want to copy, edit, copy, then go to Word file and place it. So this is done. Now I explained how to do the simulation of positive clamber circuit in LT spice, and we have obtained the input and output waveforms. From the output waveform we can confirm that the results are similar to what we have discussed in the theory part at the beginning of this video. Now I will explain how to do the simulation of negative clamber circuit by using the same circuit which you have already designed for positive clamber. The two things we need to do are the reversing the connection of the voltage source and the diode. So we need to remove the lines here. Just select the cut scissor and remove the connections from the diode and the source. You can press escape, then you can select the drag button, click, then use Ctrl R. Similarly do the same thing for the diode. Diode also need to be rotated, place it. Now complete the connections. Connections are done, we can go and do the simulation. So here, in order to perform the, while you perform the simulation, since we have all the values already there, you can minimize the window in order to see what is happening. When you click on simulate, it will not show the settings and all this time. You already selected the probes for the positive clipper, therefore it automatically generates the waveforms for the negative clipper. Have a look at the waveforms now, sorry, negative clamber. Have a look at the waveforms now. Here it is now shifted below zero. The negative clamber circuit shifted the output below zero, and that 0.7 volt is appearing above zero. Here also the output voltage is not exactly 48 volt. There is a difference. That is because of the capacitor and load resistor value. However, the results are correct. You can copy the results in the same way as we did for the positive clamber circuit. I hope this video is useful to do the simulation of clamber circuits. Thank you for watching.